So here we are in front of this beautiful body of water, something we're used to seeing. We take it for granted. It's here. Well, the day may come soon, or some may argue that it's already here, that we aren't going to be able to take for granted having a beautiful body of water like this that we can go recreate in, use for drinking, etc. Water is becoming more and more scarce, and that's leading us, even in developed countries, to reuse water, to look at water and wastewater specifically as a resource as opposed to a waste. And what that means is that we now take wastewater and intentionally reuse it for beneficial purposes. And depending on how that wastewater is treated and how it's used, there's a possibility that microorganisms in that wastewater can then get into, either back into the drinking water, or they can get on our food if that water is used for irrigation. In many other parts of the world, these microorganisms are so severe that they cause the death of more than 1 million people a year, and literally affect the lives of billions and billions of people around the world. And I've recently had an opportunity to go to East Africa and India, for example, and see really what it means to these people to even be able to get water to drink, much less being concerned about the quality of that water. There are a lot of different microorganisms that can be present in contaminated water or food. Some of them are ones that have become household names in the last few years. E. coli, for example, is a microorganism that is responsible for many, many foodborne outbreaks. In our lab, we do a few different kinds of work. Most of our efforts in the last couple of years, actually in the last several years, has been on looking at better ways to detect certain of these microorganisms. And so we've been spending a lot of time trying to develop methods that enable us to quickly detect these viruses and know when we do detect them that they actually are able to cause disease. But my interests are in looking at environmental samples. So I might be interested in going to a wastewater treatment plant, getting a sample of their wastewater and looking at, are there microorganisms in this wastewater? Are there microorganisms in the water that we're going to drink? Are there microorganisms in the Santa Ana River or in Lake Paris where people are going to go swimming? Water's becoming more and more scarce. As we have more people, there's going to be more competition for this very, very precious resource. So we can't take it for granted.